It is a headache. You can go above it, around it, but chances are if you live in the Milwaukee area, you're not going through it. Road construction. This map shows just some of the road construction in Milwaukee County this summer, from the freeways to local street projects. New at 6, 12 News Mike Anderson reports highway engineers say, hang on, the gain is going to be worth the pain.
If it looks like it's everywhere, your eyes do not deceive you. Downtown Milwaukee, the east, west, north, and south sides of the city. Road construction is everywhere.
You know what they say about Wisconsin, two seasons, winter and road construction.
The state has six major projects going on in Milwaukee County at the moment, and one of them is resurfacing Capitol Drive from Estabrook Parkway to Lake Drive. But it's not just the roads. The $11 million project also puts a new face on bicycle lanes, ramps, and pedestrian accommodations.
This is kind of a pain, but actually, if you think about it, we still have three lanes of four open. So it's not so bad. And people are acclimated, and I think now to using side roads like Wilson right over here and Oakland to be able to get around some of the construction.
The city of Milwaukee had $11 million set aside for road construction this summer, but it got a boost of $30 million more from the federal stimulus package. So the workers are going to fill many more potholes, and the city engineer says rescue some streets that were badly deteriorating. The East State Street project is one of the bigger ones.
Once it's completed, it'll have a new asphalt surface. It'll have some new sidewalks, some new curb. There's variations of types of projects that people will encounter, from complete reconstructs to projects that are simply just a resurfacing of the asphalt pavement.
Right now, it is a major inconvenience, but if you want to put your mind at ease, you might want to think about how nice it's going to be when it's all over. And the engineers say it will be all over by Thanksgiving. In Milwaukee, Mike Anderson, WISN 12 News.